Greetings.
First, he made the river in the arc of the great snake tail. When that grew tedious, he turned his attention to the cliffs, the dunes, the depths.
Normally, I'd advise you to take a leap off that ledge, but at the moment, I find myself in need of aid. Don't think you'll get anything out of it, though. I certainly won't teach you anything.
Damned kobolds is what? Poison spear to my leg and it's begun to fester. There are things for it, easy to gather myself. If I could walk... Foul stuff. I never touch it. The natural course of healing's best, if you ask me. Iron fast? What could they possibly... All right, just help me with this leg. Ugh. I'll need Spidersack Ichor, Fenrak from the canyon below, and grist from a Jotun's cookpot. Can you get me those?
An old man who's had his fill of the world.
Before the gnomes opened up that damned mine, wasn't a single one in Menetir.
It possesses a certain remarkable beauty that is hard to appreciate with a wounded leg.
Meddlers, that's what they are. Always think they know best, but they never do. Believe me.
Off in the southeast among the hills, overrun now with those spear-hefting overgrown cats. I'd keep my distance if I were you. Once in a while, some fool comes to plead on bended knee for lessons. Bah! If you don't know, there's no use telling it.
some spider sack ichor, fenrack leaf from the canyon below, and grist from a Jotun's pot. How many times must I repeat it?
Yes.
The carver made by the morning. What takes the cycles centuries to shape? He bored holes in the red marches and chiseled the spine in the Ulcerund. Echoes rang through the canyons of Menetir. He gouged the hollow lands and then left it barren. Come on.
There was another named Ohm. This name was to be feared. The name is death, decay, and violence. A cold and fading moment. A mind not of misery in the few leaves of winter. A suit of armor beneath which lay a void. Where Issa's vision was of cultured landscapes, his was of the choking weeds. Ohm's reach devoured the land. The winter approached.
Finally, the carver rested. He grew a mountain crowned with clouds by the river and leaned against its side to sleep. Ages passed, and the sand settled into his work, and all the land was still.